Hi, this is Simon, and this is the second video in our introduction to pure data. We're going to be building on what we did in the previous video, so I recommend you watch that one first. And here we have a patch built with those concepts. Let's follow the flow. We have an on-off switch that controls a metronome that's clicking once every 400 milliseconds. This bang will be able to see when that metronome is sending out a trigger. That trigger causes this object to choose a random number between 0 and 7. Again, 0 and 1 less than the number we have here as an argument. This number box will display that number that's chosen. When this number matches 0 through 7, it will be sent to those different outputs. These numbers are our note numbers that will be turned into a note with a velocity of 90 and a duration of 400 milliseconds. The make note passes that to the note out, and that's going to send out the MIDI information. Today, for sound output, I'm using Contact. This is a free sampler, Analog Dreams, clearly a kind of synthwave, vaporwave, 80s, 90s type thing. Again, let's make sure that in our preferences, MIDI, we have this Contact Virtual Input, port A. And so when I go to PD, preferences, MIDI, it's sending those MIDI messages out to the Contact Virtual Input. Okay, boom. All right, all makes sense. If we look at these, if we do a little bit of math, 48, 50, 52, 53, 55, 57, 59, 60, this is a major scale from the C below middle C up to middle C. Okay, that's neat, but let's try to play this scale in order. I'm going to need to make something that can count the number of bangs that go into it. In pure data vanilla, there's not a single object that does this, but I can do this with just three objects. For now, let me cut this and move this out of our way. I'll talk through how I'm putting this together, but if you don't follow every aspect of that, that's not really what's important. What's important is that you be able to make one yourself. I'm going to start by putting an object. Again, command one. This object is F. F in this case stands for float, but basically what this is going to do is store a number for us. So for example, if I take a message here and I type in a message of 100, run that in there, and that in there. Let's just get another number box to see what's coming out. Bink. So now, every time that bangs, it's sending out a 100. Okay, if I were to change this number to 60, bink, boom. Okay, that's not terribly useful to us yet. So what we're going to do to make this count is we're going to have it, whenever it sends out a number, we'll have it add one to that number. So again, I just did command one to put an object plus one. Okay. So now what's going to happen is 60's in here. When we bang out that 60, it's going to go through this addition of one. And so what's going to come out here is 61. Let's test. Okay, still not counting for us. So let's take now away this 60. And so instead of setting that to be 60 there, and please notice that I'm putting things in the right inlet, let's take this plus one and put it there. So what will happen now, there's still a 60 in here right now. The 60 will come out, it'll become 61. This will say 61, but it will also set this box now to be 61. So the next time a bang comes in, it sends out a 61, goes to here, it becomes a 62. Let's watch. So now we've got numbers that are incrementing. Now, the issue here, though, is we want it to start at zero. So I'm going to put down a message. I'm going to make that message negative one. Why negative one? Well, because if I start with negative one in here, the first time it goes through, it's going to add one and be zero. And so this will count up from zero. So if I click on this, every time I click on this, it resets to zero. Okay. Just for fun, why wouldn't we label that with a comment? Reset. All right. Let's now wire this one up. Again, I'm wiring a number to a number, which isn't very useful, but let's just do that and go. Hey, we got through the scale, but what's going on now? That counter's just going. I mean, I can hit reset. I'm just timing my clicks here. But if I don't click on that, it just keeps going. So how then can we get this to continuously loop through that? I'm going to add one more object, again, command one. And it's going to be a modulo. Modulos are a percent sign. What modulos do is do division and give us the remainder of it. Since I have 8 beats, I'm going to put in an 8 here. Again, don't worry about the math, but just understand that if I have 8 beats, then I want to have a modulo 8 there. So let's wire this up, and let's see what happens. So I'm going to reset. Start going. So we can see that this number keeps going up, but since I'm doing the modulo, it'll only ever go up to 8. Okay, that's kind of neat, especially if you think about the fact that now I really kind of have a sequencer here. Right now I'm just using it to go through a scale, but I could go through here and now delete these cables and think about something a little bit more clever I could do. So this is going to be the second beat. So maybe I could take this second beat, do that. I'm trying to do some math in my head as I think about what these notes are. See if I got it right. I did. So now beats 1 and 2 are playing 48, beats 3 and 4 are playing 55, beats 5 and 6 are playing 57, and then beat 7 plays 55. By the way, I've just called those beats 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 doesn't play anything, but it's important to notice that even though I'm counting like a musician, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, the computer's counting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So don't be confused about that. Okay, that's neat. Now, if I wanted a longer sequence, I could change this number to 16, for example, and then I would need select 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And I could make a sequencer based on that. Let's do something else, though. Let's combine this with random note generation. I'll duplicate this out. For now, we'll keep it at 400 milliseconds. All this is nice, but all I need instead of all this with a counter, is a random. Random 8. Straighten up my lines in a sec. So let's try this now. So now this one is choosing random numbers while this one plays through. Doesn't sound great at the moment because, first of all, it's not playing random ones, it's playing random of what I've have wired up. So let's do a few changes here. Let's start by taking away the things that are wired up to more than one thing. Okay. Also, since these are happening in the same range, the notes are going to be on top of each other. So it could be wise for me to change some of those notes. Let's go up an octave. Let's go up several octaves, actually. Let's go 72. 72 is the C above middle C. 76. 77. 79. 81. 83. 84. Let's see how that works. Not bad. We could, of course, make this one faster. 16th notes. My duration is still 400, so they're ringing out quite a bit. That's not bad, but that's too loud. Let's bring the velocity down to, I don't know, 40. I'm sort of arbitrarily picking numbers here. Okay, that's really not that bad. Let's take this a little bit further. Let's go down to our note out here. So this is the first note out. This is the one that isn't random. This is like our sequencer one. Let's set this to be note out 1. What that means is this is sending a note out on a specific MIDI channel. The reason I'm doing this is because if I set this to note out 1 and this to note out 2, I can send them to different MIDI channels. So let's listen to what's just happened. Don't expect much. All we've done is made it so we can't hear this. The reason for that, if I hop over to contact, is that this is only listening on MIDI channel 1. You can't see that immediately. If I click on I here, this is where it shows that I'm just listening on MIDI channel 1. Okay, so what I can do is go to Analog Dreams again, add another instance. By default, a new one is going to add on the next MIDI channel. So since this one up here is on MIDI channel 1, again, port A, remember we set that when we were setting our contact settings, and this is on 2. So now, hop back to PD. So my MIDI channel 1, to go back here, is Cosmic Bambino, and this one is ASMR Shivers. Let's find something nice. Too slow an attack on that one. Let's choose something with a fast attack. I have no idea about any of these presets. I'm sort of blind here. No. Well, that's a lot of mud there. Let's choose something else fast. Video gamer. We can go down here and turn down that volume too. Ah, that's much nicer. And again, this volume is only affecting the channel 2. I can turn down the channel 1 synth here too. Because they're sending the information on separate MIDI channels. Okay, that's kind of neat. Let's choose some different notes. So I did a pentatonic here and then gave us a couple more octaves of those Cs. Here's the patch that I started this video with. On-off switch goes to 3 metros, set at different rates. This one clicks every 300 milliseconds. This one every 1.2 seconds, so this is much longer. And this one, again, every 300 milliseconds. This one goes to our counter, which is counting from 0 to 8, and then I have a sequence based up there. That's all being sent out on MIDI channel 1. Here, the longer notes, random, they have a duration of 300 milliseconds, so 3 seconds, so that's actually quite long. They're being sent out on MIDI channel 2. And finally, this just every 300 milliseconds, it sends a bang that just sends a single note. No kind of selection going on at all. And that gets passed out to MIDI channel 3. If I hop over to contact, you can see I have 1, 2, 3, all listening on different MIDI channels.